In this chapter, we will learn the basic of gas turbines, one of the components in cogeneration and such utility systems. The basic principle of gas turbine, it consists mainly the compressor, as seen in this figure, and the turbine. Okay, on the left hand side of the slide, you see the basic illustration of how a single shaft gas turbine works. In a single shaft gas turbine, the compressor and turbine are mechanically connected, and they both rotating at the same speed. Air from ambient enters a combustion chamber where fuel is fired, and the temperature of the gases is raised further to a temperature. So the temperature of the gas here rise further in excess of 1500 degrees C, and some of the air from the compressor through this stream provides cooling for the combustion walls. The hot compressed mixture of air and combustion gases then flows to the inlet of the turbine. In the turbine, the gas is expanded to develop power here, to develop work, to drive the compressor. Around 2/3 of the power produced by the turbine is needed to drive the compressor, and the balance, which is the 1/3 of the work, is used to produce the power. By that mechanism, we then can calculate the net work from the gas turbine equal to the work, the overall work generated by the expander here, this unit, minus the sum of the work that is required to drive the compressor. Another type of the gas turbine is a split shaft gas turbine, as you can see from this illustration. A split shaft arrangement, you can see here, it's slightly different than the single shaft. Now that you have two turbines, this type of turbine is slightly more complex. So the first turbine here provide the power necessary to drive the compressor, and the second turbine here provide the power for the external load. More complex gas turbine configuration divide the compression and expansion into two stages with separate mechanical linkage, one between the low pressure compressor and the low pressure expander, and another between the high pressure compressor and high pressure expander in a twin pool design. Of course, there are many versions of split shaft gas turbine available in the market. On the right hand side, you see the single shaft gas turbine with recuperation. So in this type of gas turbine, the expanded gas can be discharged directly to the atmosphere. This is the flue gas, or can be used to preheat the air. You see here, this is the flue gas, and we use it to preheat the air at the exit of the compressor before entering the combustion chamber in a regenerator. Okay, this increase the, of course, because you now have some sort of heat recovery here, this process, recuperation here, increase the overall efficiency of the turbine. However, on the other side, this also increases the emission of NOx. In this slide, you see the typical the typical characteristic of gas turbines. So the size are restricted to a standard frame size ranging from 250 kilowatt to 250 megawatt. In micro turbines, the size can range from 25 kilowatt to 500 kilowatt. So that's micro turbines. The electrical efficiency is just 20 to 40%. It can be increased up to 50% for design with cool turbine blades. The exhaust temperature is pretty high, around 450 to 600 degrees Celsius. The fuels need to be at high pressure, and the fuel must be free from particulate or sulfur, because particulate can damage the blade and sulfur can corrode the blade as well. Okay, in general, gas turbine can be classified into industrial and aero gas turbine can be classified as industrial or also called as a frame machine and aero derivative machine that are lighter in weight, derived from the aircraft engine. You can see in this table it compare the two type of industrial turbine. Industrial turbine normally has a lower pressure ratio of up to 15. It's more robust, lower in efficiency, lower in specific cost, and then the size typically up to 250 megawatt. On the other hand, the aero derivative machine can operate at high pressure ratio up to 30, light, more efficient, more expensive, and smaller in size, up to 50 megawatt. So the aero derivative gas turbines are typically used for offshore application where weight and efficiency are premium, to drive compressors for natural gas pipelines, and standalone power generation application for peak periods of high power demand. For standalone application, gas turbine efficiencies become very critical. However, if heat is to be recovered from the gas turbine exhaust, the efficiency becomes less important as the waste heat is utilized.